Sheila-na-gig. Now, I'd never heard tell of them before. So we've done a wee bit of research, as you do, before coming to see it. And this was the debate whether it was pre-Christian or when Christianity stepped into Ireland and changed the whole meaning of it. And you may not be able to see, but we'll show a photograph of it in a moment. In Ireland, apparently there are 101. They're carvings, they're stone carvings on wall. Now, if it was pre-Christianity, it's of a figure of a lady sitting, well, it's not actually a woman, a female, but it's the, you know, it's the feminine, sitting with her legs apart and showing her feminine regions. Pre-Christianity, it was a sign of fertility and, of course, the magical thing of the energy, the divine energy that the woman, the female, holds within her. Now, step in Christianity, they have a different meaning behind it all. They said it was the lustful, it was the sinful figurine, and it was to ward off evil spirits. The wonderful history that we have in Ireland, Sheila-na-gig, and I'm so delighted that I got to come here today because I always speak about the divine feminine of our power and how the power had been taken away from us over many years. But the divine feminine is also within the male, and I am putting my bets on it that this was pre-Christianity. And it's all about fertility, it's all about love, it's all about the divine feminine, and it's all about the power.